Purdue, as you all know, has an incredible history in aviation that we can trace all the way to the Wright brothers. Purdue graduate Cliff Turpin learned to fly from Orville Wright. Cliff Turpin helped the brothers improve their engine and controls and became one of the original Wright flyers, demonstrating flying machines, as they called them, to the nation. This Purdue airport was the first university airport in the nation, and the history of flight has passed down these runways from legends such as Wiley Post and Amelia Earhart to our astronauts, and some of them learned to fly here. Our aviation technology department gave birth to our College of Technology, now led by Dennis. Purdue Aviation Technology is considered among the best in the world. Purdue was the first university in the nation to offer a bachelor's degree in aviation technology. Today, we're taking the next step with this great program. Today, we're walking into the future of aviation technology at Purdue and assuring its leadership in this new century.
We should first learn by getting the very best education possible, which then allows us to earn, and the opportunity then to return the blessings that we've been given. Giving is what we do for others who will follow. I hope this gift and new facility will ensure that Purdue continues to produce not only the best pilots and aviation specialists in the world, but the best people for generations to come.
Scott and Nikki see the vision, the angel in the marble, and they become immersed in the cause, and with heart and soul and a tremendous amount of passion, they chisel away at the barriers that hinder progress, and they sculpt a future. So too with our new aviation technology addition. Scott's worked very closely during this whole time with the university in designing of this building that we'll be seeing here in just a moment, a rendering of it. And he did that because of his passion for ensuring that students and faculty receive true maximum benefit from this facility.
And so it's going to give our students state-of-the-art classrooms and our faculty state-of-the-art classrooms in which to teach, and it's going to provide us new collaborative space. We have a growing discovery and engagement footprint that's international in scope, and we'll have new collaborative space for students, faculty, and our industry and governmental partners to engage. It represents a vision of Scott Neiswanger in particular, and of the faculty and the staff and the students of our department.